They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because they would never understand.
Yes, the internet trolls are doing their best to try and get to us, but let's not let it happen. Please subscribe to the channel and follow my social links. What's happening, guys? It's B-Rad and welcome back to the TOTS RTG. After yet another weekend struggling with champs, mainly because I just absolutely despise the mode, I'm now going to do something fun in this episode. I haven't done a draft on this account yet, and I have two tokens to dispose of. So, obviously, it's going to come up and tell me, as it is now, that we've not done a draft before because it is a brand new account, but we'll get into it and do all this. Big things are coming up soon. Rock, Paper, Stat is now going to be a series that I will be taking over from the main man, Oaklefish. So you can expect to see that on the channel next week or some point maybe during this week. And hopefully we're going to get some of the old guests on, some of the old familiar faces, and some new guests as well. And there's also going to be an introduction of a wheel from myself for the third power up. So you're going to get two guaranteed, and the third power up will be decided by a wheel. And it's going to always be first to 15, just so that we do player picks and things. It's not too short or too long a video. So I'm looking forward to doing that. Looking forward to recording it. And just ever grateful that Oakley's agreed to let me take that series into my hands. So we start off with a Cruyff who, you know, what I love about draft is this guy can play center forward and striker. Yeah, in the 4-2-2, it's popped him at cam. So he's off chemistry. Yeah, I love this game. Okay. Oh, 92 winter wildcard Salah. We'll take that as well. Nice. Absolute dreadful bunch of non-rare golds there. And an equally dreadful gold rare in that left cam spot. But we've got a good one coming here. Ramirez UCL card. We will take that. I haven't really used him much this year, actually. But it'd be nice to see what he's like. And then alongside him, Camavinga. That looks like a very nice card as well. Left back, Galazzo, Roberto Carlos. Thank you very much. Left centre back, team of the year, Ruben Diaz. We're cooking now. Right centre back, Canate or Blanc? I feel like we should take Blanc because he is versatile and can play other spots. So let's take Blanc. Right back. No one good there, so we'll take Wan-Bissaka. Goalkeepers, a non-rare gold. Hopefully we're going to get a better goalkeeper in this subs position. We are. Well, we've got Areola, the Mr. Nipples himself. Then next defenders, we've got Kimpembe or Scott. I think we'll take Scott because that's probably the best for chemistry. So we need, really, just a cam and a striker to finish off this team. Preferably from the Prem. We will take Timber because he's quite good. Who have we got here then? Centre mid Pedri, centre mid Valverde. Can he play cam? No. Can Pedri play cam? He can. Let's take Pedri then. He's not getting any extra chemistry. Oh, it's because he's on full cam. And then, okay. Do we go Schneider or Kaká? Five star for Schneider. And four star for Kaká. We're going to go Wesley Schneider. Get him in that left cam spot. Well, actually, technically, we're going to get him in the right cam spot and put Cruyff up top because Cruyff has been put into the wrong position. And there we go. 32 chemistry. The person off chem is... Who is off chem? Oh, Pedri. Okay. So we could either... we could do with another cam or just putting him onto chemistry somehow. UCL road to the knockouts, Haaland. I think I prefer him over Salah, if I'm honest. I don't particularly like Salah on this game. But it's a good sub to have, I suppose. Oh, Jadon Sancho. Hello, buddy. He can only play left wing or left mid, so we'll have to sub him on if we're going to use him. In the 4-2-2, we've got Teller. He's a very good card to have on the bench as well. This is looking like a pretty good draft, to be fair. Because hello, foot birthday, Mane. Yeah, we're starting to build something pretty nice here. We could do with maybe a wing back for cover, like Cafu. Wow. Okay. Asking, you shall receive. Cafu is in for Scott. Scott can sit on the bench. So we've got an all special card bench other than Wan-Bissaka. We'll get him taken out in a minute. And replace him for a 94-foot birthday Messi. Yeah, why not? Yeah. Yeah. This draft, I mean, I'm not good at the game, so don't now go and think I'm going to go and win this draft, but I've got as good a chance as any, especially as we then get Cristiano Ronaldo as well. So, yeah, we're looking pretty good in this draft. This is a pretty crack draft. Looks very nice indeed. We'll finish it off with Pellegrini in manager position, and we'll see how we can get on in this draft. Right, so before I actually get into playing the draft, it has now been a few days and I have ticked over to Ligue 1 Tots, and I cannot believe the weekend I was going to go 20-0 on the RTG to get Mbappe, that people have managed to get him for 6 or 9 wins. I mean, you guys know me. I've never gone 20-0. And to be fair, if you manage to beat the system and get those games in and get an Mbappe in your red picks, all credit to you for getting it done that quickly and getting it done, because we know EA are pretty much corrupt, and this just shows it, because they seemingly gave an even pack weight amongst the red picks. I don't think it favored Mbappe and Dembele. I've seen about 20 red picks being opened, and there was probably about 6 Mbappes, 6 Dembele's, a lot of Zaire Emery's, a lot of them, but no, I don't think there was any more Mbappe's than, like, you know, there would be a normal standard card. I don't think there was extra Mbappe's to be had. I think it was even, and I just think that they decided to basically say, oh, hang on a minute, sorry, we've given you a very good card on an even pack weight. That's not meant to happen. We'll take it back. And that's just another credit and another reason why you shouldn't buy FC points, because what they're telling you is they can lower the pack weight of these cards. Now, don't get me wrong, the best cards in the game shouldn't be the easiest cards to get. I do get that. But it's a little bit corrupt, isn't it? Let's face it. Especially when you're spending your hard-earned money on FC points and things. Anyway, I digress. What I'm going to do is a Ligue 1 sort of type pack opening for you. Open my packs that were saved for this promo and do that first, so you'll see any decent pulls now, and then we'll get into the draft gameplay, and there might be 2 drafts, we'll see. Let's get into it. Oh, Tots in a preview pack. No, he hasn't got one, has he? You are kidding me. If it's his coins, well, this is a 7.5k preview pack. What a way to start off the Ligue 1 Tots on the RTG. Oh my god. That's unreal. Coins in the club, baby. Let's go. Okay, we've got a mega pack with Rolfo in it. That's the only walkout. I did have an Odegaard in one of the 11 packs, 11 player packs that you get from the gold upgrades. But I forgot to put it in. So, yeah, that's the only thing that we've had so far. Nothing particularly great, but we are now getting towards the best packs. So, hopefully something better on the horizon. But I mean, to say something better, preview pack, Tots to Bamiyang. Happy days. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and claim our free Jared Bowen team of the season. Might well find his way into our team, to be honest. However, that being said, we now have some coins to play with, which is a very interesting situation on RTG, because not many people have coins these days. But you will see that already Aubameyang has sold for a whopping 395,000 coins. So going into Foot Champs this weekend, we have got a great potential to improve our team. But anyway, that's nothing to be thinking about now, because this episode is a draft episode. We've already built it. You saw us build it. Let's get into it and see how far we can get. Here we go. 1-0 up, but Cruyff. Let's go. And then, yep, finesse shot, of course. Not even finesse plus either. Wow. And another finesse. Brilliant. Okay. Thought they'd been patched. Maybe not. Okay. I did not see that he had that. I didn't look at his team, to be fair. There we go. Other one back. 3-2. Yeah, another finesse shot. Pretty sure every single goal has been out, hasn't it? Okay. That Mia Hamm's causing us problems. There we go. The sixth or fifth finesse goal. Green timed, I'm out of here. We'll start another draft and yeah, let's see if we get a decent team. Draft token pack. Our luck's in. Our luck is in. There we go. This is the team we got in the draft. Very good up front and in midfield. Unfortunately, you only got Wan-Bissaka at right back and no one really to replace him there. The only thing we could maybe do is put Kimpembe at right back. He's got 86 pace, because we don't really want to put Blanc. He's not really good enough either. And then maybe put Kiwior or Jonathan Tah in, or maybe put Tah at right center, right back. Who knows? But let's get into it and see if we can do better than the last one. Nice. Come out of nowhere, to be fair. Real promise now. Chance to level it up now from the corner. It's put into the middle. It's there. There we go. That didn't last long. They're back level already. 1-1. That Henry card is very, very good. One through ball gets in. Never mind. Here we go again. And we get a cheesy goal back. Okay. Defense just seem to be absent. I should have set some custom tactics, to be fair, but that still doesn't affect the centre backs. Oh, that was my chance to get a goal back. Not obviously get drawing, but that's terrible by Omri. Really terrible. Yeah. That again. So we'll end the episode. Well, not end the episode on this. We're going to end the episode on a tots pack, but we won't do any more drafts. Two first round defeats. We've still got another draft token available. And obviously, if we do get another one here. Nah, we're pushing our luck. Then we'd add another one. But yeah, we'll go and do a tots pack to finish off this episode. See if we can get something amazing. Here we go then. Bundesliga tots upgrade complete. Hopefully we're going to pack ourselves a banger in there, but we have got some other packs to open just to lead up to it. But I'll let you know what the plan is for the next episode. And there's obviously going to be a change to the schedule of things. I have alluded to it on my community on YouTube that I need to set up a new schedule because I've got a new job that I start on Monday. So I need to kind of arrange to do my content around that. So obviously that pays the bills, pays the mortgage. That's the most important thing. So I don't want to burn out on trying to do content after work and things like that, and sort of end up letting one suffer for the other, etc. So what I'm going to do is set up a new new schedule for myself, and basically I'll let you guys know what that's going to be. It'll still be like probably 6 or 7 days worth of content, but it's just about when I can get those videos out and what is going to be in those videos. Kramaric in this one. But yeah, for the next RTG episode, it's basically going to be, I'm going to have done off camera the Ligue 1 cup or lounge, season lounge or whatever it is, to complete that there, to get some players from that and also get a guaranteed tots pack of things. So we'll open that for the next start of the next episode. Then we will play a couple of games with the team before I look to see where I'm going to spend the money. Now we've got coins to use. I don't want to just use them. I need to be careful and you know, I need to think about where I'm using them. So we'll do that. And then we'll see where we're at. But Bundesliga starts to finish this off because the rest of our packs were pretty lackluster compared to our preview gold pack. So let's go. Bundesliga Tots guarantee. Kobel. I mean, it's great for fodder. Great in terms of rating for fodder. But yeah, he's not going to get in our team. He's just not. We got, we had a Tots Allison that we packed tradable. I sold it for Van der Sar, and Kobel doesn't fit in at the moment. So yeah, catch those episodes coming up to you soon. Catch the schedule coming out to you soon as well. I hope you are enjoying this RTG and stick with me all the way through Tots. Also, we'll have Rock Paper Stat coming to my channel, as well as other things on my other account, like team takedowns and things like that as well. So yeah, stay tuned. Hopefully, it's still all going to be good stuff. As always, thanks for tuning in. I've been B-Rad.